All right, now we're going to go ahead and flush the printer. Now, this is important. If ever you're going to go inactive without using the printer, you need to flush the ink out of the line. And not only do you need to flush the ink out of the line, but you need to keep your cleaning solution in the printer as if it were ink. We're going to start here by taking off this blue cover so we can see. This is basically the same thing as filling it with ink, only we're filling it with cleaning solution. Remove the three screws that hold this blue cover on. All right, now with the screws removed, gently lift the cover up and away. And if you have your ink bottle cover on, remove that as well. Before we begin flushing, we need to make sure that we have emptied our waste container. If we have a partially full container here, we can overflow waste ink into this compartment down here, which will leak out and drip all over the place. While we're doing this flushing process, we will fill this bottle up, so we need to check it periodically. Now, to begin, we need to have the original bottles that came with the machine, or if you don't have the original bottles, or for example, the white ink bottles you had to use, then you'll need to take the ink and pour it out of the bottles and then clean the bottles out so that we can put our cleaning solution in. All right, let's begin switching out the bottles here. And when we remove the cap, be careful not to drip ink all over the place. And you definitely want to go ahead and take a paper towel and wipe the excess ink that's on the outer side of the tube. And go ahead and clip the tubes until we're ready to actually flush. Replace it with our bottle of cleaning solution. And now we need to do the same for all seven bottles. Okay, now we're ready to begin the flushing. We could actually open up all these clips, press the ink fill button, and flush everything at once, but none of these tubes are going to flush out at the same rate, especially the white tubes. We're going to take a lot more. So to maintain more control over this, it's going to be best to do it one at a time. So we will start with yellow, and we'll unclip, and we'll press the ink fill. Now what we're watching for is the cleaning solution flushing the ink out of the lines, and we need to get every ounce of ink out of these tubes. Now you will see that some of these colors of inks will stain the tube a certain color. That's okay, but what we need to make sure of is that we don't see any little traces of ink anywhere in the low points of these tubes. What's inside the tube needs to be completely clear. We want to keep flushing and watch all the way to these last tubes. These last tubes we see here are what feed into the damper, which feeds into the printhead. Once you see that it looks pretty clear here, you may want to hold for another 5-10 seconds so that we can get the last bits of ink out of the damper and out of the printhead. Once it looks clear, we can stop. We'll want to reclip the yellow and move on to the next one here, the first white or the light magenta. Unclip it and press ink fill. Now the white lines take a lot more time to flush out. The white ink residue that's left in the lines tends to stick to the inner walls of the tube, so we need to flush and flush until we see it all going through. And you'll see white, little white trails in low-lying areas. We need to get all of that out. Again, keep watching the tubes. As you see now from the bottle, it looks clean. But still up here, we see white in the tube, so we need to keep flushing. Sometimes with the white lines too, it may help if you take and pull the cap out, let a little air go through, and then put the cap back down in, it'll start drawing cleaning solution again, and you see how it's coming through and picking up some of that white residue that was left behind. Everything's looking good. We still got a little residue left down here. It's coming through cleaner now. Now that looks pretty clean, I'm gonna hold for another 5 seconds or so, and then we'll move on to the next one. All right, we need to reclip that white line or the light magenta, and we need to open the magenta and repeat. Magenta looks good now. I'll hold for a few more seconds. And we'll repeat. Clip the magenta that we just did and undo the next white, which is light cyan here. Press ink fill. Hold for a few more seconds. And clip that line. Now we're moving on to the cyan. Unclip it. And press the ink fill. We're going to hold it for a few more seconds. And clip the cyan. And unclip the next white, the gray or the light black. Press the ink fill. Now that last little bit of white's gone through, we'll hold for a few more seconds. And now we'll clip it and unclip the last one. And black sometimes can be a little bit more tricky and take a little bit more fleshing than the rest of the colors. Now the black line looks like it's clean and flush, so we'll hold for a few more seconds. And done. Now if you look at the cleaning solution, it's now been a little bit contaminated by the ink that was on the outer tubes. You can never get every little trace of ink, plus the ink that's down here in the little tip of the tube will always get a little trace into the cleaning solution. If you're using distilled water, same thing. So what we want to do now is go ahead and change all of these out with fresh cleaning solution, and we're going to do one more final flush and then do several head cleanings. But before we begin, we need to check our waste bottle, see how our waste bottle is filled up. We definitely need to dump that before we begin. Now we're ready to go. Okay, now that we've got our fresh cleaning solution or distilled water there, we want to make sure all the clips are open. And we're going to go ahead and press the ink fill button. We're going to give it a little bit more of a flush to get the contaminated solution out of the lines. You can kind of see it flushing clear. You can even see some bubbles from where we changed the bottles over. When we don't see any more bubbles or everything looks clear, the yellow is one that definitely the tube stained because of the color of ink. But the rest of them are pretty crystal clear. Hold for a few more seconds. We're making sure we're getting the dampers good and flushed. And now that we've gotten the lines and tubes flushed real good, we can release the ink fill. We've got cleaning solution all the way through the tubes, all the way through the dampers, and through the printhead. Now, to make sure we get the printhead now completely flushed of any remaining ink residue, we're going to run several head cleanings with this cleaning solution in there instead of ink. That way the printhead itself, the crystal inside that's firing the jets, is what's actually pushing that cleaning solution through each individual jet. I would recommend doing 10 or 20 of these, to be honest. The more you do, the better. It's not going to hurt anything. Just make sure you don't overflow your waste tank. Press and hold the ink for 3 seconds, and it'll begin a cleaning cycle. Let's repeat and do another one. Press and hold for 3 seconds. And when you've done your last cleaning cycle, the printhead is, and the whole entire system is now completely flushed and purged of ink. But we want to keep this solution in the printer. If the printer is going to sit idle for any length of time, this is the best way to keep the printer in hibernation mode to prevent any kind of clogging at all. These jets are very small, and it's very easy for them to clog. So without touching anything else on the ink fill or the ink button, we just want to go ahead and close these clips so that there's no chance that the solution can backflow into the bottles. And after that, we can turn the printer off, we can unplug it, we can leave it rest.